Potentiometer. What is the potentiometer? First of all, let us see the requirement of potentiometer. Potentio, it leads to potential. Meter means calculating or measuring something. So we have already seen for a battery, the terminal voltage was V equal to E minus IR. E was the EMF of the battery, R was the internal resistance of that battery. In this figure, if this voltmeter is used in lab, say table voltmeter, which is across two terminals A and B of a battery, this is a battery, then it will measure the potential difference between these two points A and B, right? A two terminals of a battery, or a terminal voltage you can say V. So this equation reduces to V equal to E. Why? If the internal resistance is zero, if this part is zero, V is equal to E, right? Or you can say that when there is no current, I is zero. When there is no current through the battery, I equal to zero, then V will be equal to exactly equal to the EMF of the battery, EMF of the battery. But the internal resistance can never be zero. There will always be some internal resistance. So the voltmeter will measure the EMF of a battery only if no current is drawn. Because R cannot be zero, it will always be there. So if there is no current, then only we can say that it is going to measure. That means if I is equal to zero, current is not flowing, that means it's an open circuit. So the resistance of an ordinary voltmeter is approximately in the range of 5000 ohm to 6000 ohm. This is the resistance of ordinary voltmeter. So a small amount of current which flows through the battery when connected to a voltmeter. So this means that voltmeter measure only the terminal voltage and not the EMF of the battery. Okay, it will measure, the voltmeter is going to measure only the terminal voltage, not the EMF, right? So we want to measure the EMF also, EMF of battery. So we need to design a new device, new instrument, in which the open circuit condition I equal to zero needs to be achieved, and this device is exactly called as potentiometer. This is what we are discussing. So potentiometer is that device in which we can obtain continuously varying potential difference between any two points which can be measured simultaneously, right? So what is the principle of potentiometer? In this figure, a battery of EMF E, this is battery of EMF E, and it is having internal resistance, this is R, connected in series with the resistance box RB. This is a resistance box having a resistance R and a very long resistive wire of uniform cross-sectional area. So this is a long wire, you know, this is all long wire. So we have to note that the resistance box R is not always necessary to connect, it is an option. So, if in potentiometer, a long piece of uniform wire few meters in length across which his battery is connected is clamped on a meter scale. This is very important, which is mounted on a wooden platform. It's just not lying there. So, there is a formation. So, let us assume that the length L of the length of the potentiometer wire AB from this point to this point is L meter. Right? It's L meter. And rho is the resistance per unit length of that wire. So what will be the resistance of wire? If rho is resistance per unit length, what will be resistance? Rho into L, we are saying that capital L is the length. So L into rho will be the resistance. So if R is the resistance of the resistance box, this RB, then the current flowing through wire AB can be easily found out by Ohm's law. V equal to IR, E equal to IR. So I is this is EMF, and the total resistance is this resistance RB plus L rho of this wire, and then this small R. So this whole L is the small L. If you take, this is the whole current. Now let us take small L. This is the length of the wire from A to C, means from this point to this point, this is small L. This point to this point, smaller. and L rho, because if capital L rho is the resistance of the wire AB, then small L rho will be the resistance of this part, small part, AC. So, potential difference between AC will be what? I by rho, right? So, the potential difference is, if you denote it by VL, A and C, it is given by IL rho. This is IL rho, sorry. This is I into L into rho. Why? Because this is resistance. When we multiply it by I, then we get V. That is what we are saying. VL for this length equal to I into L into rho. Now, let us substitute the value of I from this equation, to this equation. So, we are putting I as this into this equation. So, we get this. So, ultimately, all these are known. These are fixed. When we take the length, if you vary the length, that means the potential is directly proportional to the length, because this is constant. These values are known to us. So, this potential at for some length, say AC or any length you can take, it is directly proportional to the length L. Now we come to the principle. As we saw the discussion, the potential difference between any two points of the potentiometer wire, say VL, is directly proportional to the distance between that two points. And when we take different L, or different potential difference can be obtained. Point A to C of the wire, as we saw, behave as that they, if they are positive or negative terminals of a battery. If you change it to the position C with the help of a jockey, the EMF of battery can be varied. So, this sigma, this is potential per unit length, and when we put the value, we get this equation. So, the potential difference per unit length of the wire, which is V L, V sub L by L, is sigma. This is called the, this is known as the potential gradient. V L is potential per unit length, is the potential gradient, which is, it is given in volt per meter. So, the sensitivity of the potentiometer depends on the potential gradient of that wire, along the wire, you can say. So, smaller the potential gradient, that means greater will be the sensitivity of the potentiometer. For any given VAB, which potential from A to B, the sensitivity of potentiometer can be increased if you increase the length of the potential wire, and thereby you can decrease also by decreasing the length. What are the uses of this potentiometer? We can compare EMFs of two sets. Let us take an example. This E1 and E2, these are the EMFs of two cells which are to be compared using the or employing the potentiometer. For this job, the EMF E of the driver cell, that is the main battery here in potentiometer, should be greater than this E1 and this E2. And this has to be determined. So, if you see this figure, firstly the positive terminal of a cell E1, this is connected to end A of the potentiometer wire, and the negative of this E1 is connected to jockey through a sensitive galvanometer. Right? Like this. We'll do it for E2 also. So, now the jockey is moved along the wire AB. This is whole wire AB. We can just take it here, anywhere you can take along the wire till the galvanometer shows no deflection. Let us assume that the position is C1, where there is no current, no flow of current. So, in this condition, no current is flowing through this cell E1. Therefore, its terminal voltage is equal to the, it will be equal to its EMF. Terminal voltage, that is V, will be equal to E only, because V equal to E minus IR, there is no current, so V will be equal to E. So, here in this case, it is E1. So, terminal voltage is equal to E1. Now, such a point on the wire, we call it as a null point. Let us suppose that the null point, this C1, is at say distance L1 from point A. From this point to this point, this length is, from this point to this point, it is L1 from A. So if it is a balanced condition, the potential difference between this A point and C1 point of the wire should be equal to the EMF of cell, so this E1, because we are saying that the current is not flowing. We have come to a point through Jokin where is no current. Now we have an equation. We say from V, potential V, from A to C1 is simply equal to E1 because there is no current. And this is sigma into L1. And sigma we know, it is given by A into rho R plus L into rho plus R. This is the potential gradient, the sigma into L1. Now we are inserting a plug key K2, which is this. Battery E2, this one is connected in place of E1. This was connected because of K1. Now we'll plug on K2. Now E2 will be connected. Again, we'll do the same thing for E2. We have to slide this C1, or we have to slide this jockey so that this current becomes zero. Let us say that this is a C2 point where we get current equal to 0. Balancing length AC2 from A to C2 is L2. So this is the balancing point now for this E2. Again, same thing, VAC2 will be equal to E2 equal to sigma L2. Now we'll take this one and we'll take this one and divide them. So what do we get? E1 by E2 will be equal to L1 by L2. And with this equation, the EMF of two cells can be compared. And in practice, if you see, the EMF of a cell is determined by comparing it with the EMF of a standard cell, right? So we can employ this equation. We can also obtain desired value of this potential difference between any two points of the wire by choosing appropriate value of resistance, this R, as resistance box. Because the potential difference of the order of 10 to the power minus 6 volt, that is 1 microvolt, or order of 1 millivolt 10 to the power minus 3 volt can be obtained here. Potentiometer can be employed if you want to measure very, very small EMF of this range. Now, if one thing need to be ascertained, that if two cells of EMF E1 and E2 are they first connected in helping condition and then in opposing condition, that is, say this is like this and the other one is like this. So what do we get? If two cells of EMF E1 and E2 are first connected in helping condition, then in opposing condition. So what will happen? The length of the null point is respectively, you say L3 and L4. So it will be L3 plus L4 by L3 minus L4. This is what is going to happen. Now, in order to determine the internal resistance of a cell, what do we have to do? We have to determine the internal resistance of a cell. So we can use potentiometer in order to measure the internal resistance of a cell. If you see this figure, the cell which with EMF E, this is cell with EMF E, whose internal resistance R is to be determined. We want to find out the internal resistance which is connected across a small resistance box, or capital R you can say. This is a resistance box. And there is a key. If you on the key, it will be connected. If you off the key, it will not be connected to the circuit. So, null point say C1 is obtained in potentiometer wire when this key K2 is open, when resistance box is not connected. So, at this time, there will be no flow of current. There will be no flow of current through this cell because the key is not connected, which is called the open circuit. Now, if this cell null point C1 is obtained at say distance L1, from point A, say from this point, then we have already known that that is potential from A to C1 is simply equal to this E. And this will be sigma L1. L1 is the distance from A to the C1. Now, when we press this K2, or you can say when K2 is closed, the resistance box will come in the circuit. And this null point C2 is again obtained on the wire at say some appropriate value of R. So, if the terminal voltage of cell is V and the null point is now obtained to be L2, previously it was L1. Now, when we press this key, we obtain AC2 as L2. So, this VAC2 will be equal to V and this is equal to sigma into L2. So, ultimately what we got? Epsilon by V, we divide these two, equal to L1 by L2. Sigma gets cancelled. We are dividing these two. So this E by V equal to L1 by L2, but we know that the by Ohm's law, E will be equal to I, like V equal to IR. So EMF is equal to I and external resistance plus internal resistance. So in place of E, we can write IR plus R. That is exactly what we are doing here. We will put E as I into R plus R. So this V will be equal to IR. We will put V equal to IR. So this equation becomes R, capital R plus R by small r, and L1 by L2. Okay. Now from here we can find out the internal resistance. You can take others on the right hand side. This is the equation by which we can find the internal resistance of this cell.